billing system related articles in following site: www.pinepad.in/blog, or go to Java Technologies billing system. This is my site, pinepad.in. When you click blog, it will return all Java related technical articles. If you want to see only specific to billing system, go to Java Technology, click billing system. This will return only billing system related articles. Okay. Please follow me on medium.com. The reason I am saying is, if you follow me on medium.com, you will be getting all notification. You will be getting notification if I post any articles in pinepad.in or medium.com. This is the link which is from pinepad.in. This particular post contains all YouTube links which related to billing system. Okay, I will show that. See, billing system using Spring Boot, all YouTube video links updated here. This post contains all YouTube link that related to billing system. Okay. This information I have updated on YouTube description, on YouTube video description. Okay. Please check it out. Welcome back, friends. In this video, I'll going to talk about tax table. I have completed the crude operation of tax table, and I have completed the crude operation of product table, product item table, offer table, categories table. There are many work I have done part of billing system. Actually, I wanted to explain about the product table and the product item table, but I cannot explain directly product and product item. But I cannot explain directly product and the product item table, because this product table depends on some tables. Those are tax table, category table, and the offer table. First I want to explain these three tables, then we'll go into the product table and the product item table. In this video, I'll going to explain about the tax table. When you look at the tax table, there is a two important column called HSN and the tax percentage. HSN code is nothing but it's a unique code. That code associated with a set of products. Let me explain about the HSN code using some diagrams. See, this is HSN code we have. Let's assume that this is HSN code we have, 902922. This 902922 HSN code mapped with one GST percentage, GST tax percentage called 5%. Each HSN code associated with multiple product. Each HSN code associated with a multiple product. According to this diagram, there are 6 products associated with the HSN code. That meaning the 6 product GST percentage is 5%, because this HSN code mapped with the GST is 5%. That meaning this 5% applied to all these 6 product. Through this way, we need to associate a GST tax to particular product. Let's forget about this product part. In this video, we're going to focus how to add tax, how to add tax data through our billing system. Let's say controller class now. There is a tax controller controller class I have created. This tax controller class auto void with tax services. In this tax services, there is a 3 methods I have defined. One is save, another one is find the resource by ID, another one is find all. That's it. 3 methods I have implemented. In this tax service, I have implemented tax repository. The tax repository does not have any method. I'll going to use default method from the tax repository, which is coming from the JPA repository. In this tax service, there is a serve method. The serve method accepting the one parameter called tax info. This tax info is having HSN code, tax percentage, and tax description. That's it. This tax info should contain all those information, tax percentage, tax description and HSN code. I am converting this tax info to my entity object called tax. Then in the tax repository save method, I am passing this tax data, tax object. This will store in our tax table. This will store in our tax table. Then return a new tax. The new tax object contains that with ID. This tax does not have ID. After saving the data to the table, this save return the tax information with a new ID. Then again converting this tax, new tax object to my tax info object. This tax info I am returning back to in our client side as a response after successful creation of tax. This save method I am calling instead of controller class. The controller class, there is a one method called save method. The serve method parameter is I'm passing request body, I'm passing two annotation at valid at request body. Using at valid, I'm saying that please validate all the fields available in the tax info. Using at valid at request body, I'm saying that tax info is a request body of this particular endpoint. Whatever data client entering their side, those information come in this structure. Those information come in this structure. Okay, once you get the tax info, I am passing tax service reserve method. This will save the data in the database, then returning the response message. This response message binded with the tax info object. Tax info response object. That response object I am printing in the client side with created state. With HTTP status as a created state. This is adding and updating for tax. Another one is get mapping. Get mapping of ID, I am passing ID. Whenever you pass any ID, for that ID, I am returning the tax data and assigning back to the response message. That response message I am displaying to the client side. When you look at the find resource by ID, the find resource by ID, here I am passing this ID to find by ID method from the repository object. This find by ID return the corresponding tax object. This corresponding tax object I am converting to tax info. Tax info, the tax info I am converting to a response object using, sorry, I am converting as a response message using response dot with response data. This return a response message. That response message I return it back to controller class. Get all return all tax data which is stored in our database. When you look at the tax service class, there is a find all method. This find all return all the tax data by calling find all method from tax repository. This find all method return tax list. This tax list I'm iterating. Each iteration I'm converting this tax to the tax info, then adding this tax info to the new list called tax info. This tax info returning back as a response message to the client side. These are through simple crude operation I have done for tax. Actually, we should not add the tax data one by one. We need to get the real tax data in the Excel sheet. The Excel sheet we need to input to the backend system. Backend system should read that all the tax data. Then it should populate those tax data in the tax table. That is the right way to do that. Definitely, I'll going to implement that particular functionality soon. This is about the tax table. Okay. Now we're going to see the demo. Okay. I already opened the Postman. This is the endpoint of tax. Endpoint of adding or updating a tax. Here I'm going to say HSN code is 1111. Tax percentage is 7. Then shirts. Okay, tax description is the shirts. When you look at the database tax table, we have only two rows. I'm sending the request. It's a creator. I'm getting the response back here. Tax saved successfully. Message type info. Then whatever message I entered that is coming here along with new ID. So here the tax HSN code is 1111 shirts and the percentage is 7%. Now I want to update this. I want to update to 12. See here, it's updated to 12. Oh, sorry, it's created. I should not do like this. Whenever you want to update a record, we need to pass the ID. I forgot to pass the ID here. That's the reason it's created a new row. Now I want to update the fourth record. This record I want to update. I want to update fourth record. Let's go to change everything. Say 2222. Then tax percentage is 15, 18. Then description is something. Okay, I'll going to send now. Now it's updated. Fourth record is updated. When you refresh this, when you refresh the fourth record, it will give updated value. See, HSN code 222, percentage is 18%, then something. Description is a something. So add and update is working fine. Now I want to retrieve by ID. If you want to retrieve by ID, you can say slash something, some ID. I want to view second. I want to view second one. This is a get, right? The second, when you, if you want to view some record, that is a get mapping. You need to use get. So second record is coming. I want to view fourth one. Fourth record is coming. I want to view all. For that, just remove it. Then send. Now we'll getting everything. I'll copy and paste in JSON editor. You can see all the records. See, all the records are coming now. The four records are coming. Four records. 0, 1, 2, 3. This is about tax table. I hope you understand about the tax table. I have updated all the source code in the repository. From now on, I'll going to stop sharing my repository. You cannot pull a code from the repository. Instead of that, I am providing some alternative way. Go to downloads. In this site, go to pinepad.in, go to downloads. From the downloads, you can, if you click the downloads, you will get this page. From here, you can click download button. When you click download button, you will be getting the latest code of our billing system. Or you can go here, Java Technologies Downloads. The same page will come. Click download button, downloading a latest code of billing system. Okay. Please share this channel to a friend circle and colleagues. People who are looking for real-time experience, please share this channel, those kind of people. In the next video, we're going to talk about offer table and a categories table. After that, we're going to focus on product and the product item table. Product and product item table. Until then, bye-bye from Suresh. Still not subscribe this channel, please subscribe it, share this video to your friend circle, click bell icon for regular updates. Thanks for watching this full video.